Tonight we're going to start with this session with a question. And the question is this: where are those who ask that where is the imam is mentioned in the Quran? In other words, Is there any ayah in the Quran which talks about the imamate or al-imam in Islam? They say, why do you believe in 12 imams? There is no ayah in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you and I must obey 12 imams. Where is it in the Quran? There is no such ayah in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is requiring from mu'mineen to obey Allah or to obey the a'imma of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. Is there such ayah in the Quran or no? Tonight, while we are commemorating the shahada of Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi afdalu salatu wasalam, we want to find out, is there any ayah in the Quran where Allah talks about the imam in the Quran, or there is none? So that when we leave this majlis tonight, we have some ayahs or some proof from the Quran and from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in regards to the imam in Islam. The answer is this. We say, of course. See, the Quran doesn't talk to the dumbs. Quran talks to the people who are smart. That's why you see that most of the ayahs in the Quran, when Allah does it, لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, the people of understanding. أَفَلَا يَتَفَكَّرُونَ أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you and I to understand that this Quran is for special people who are smart. And see, when you speak to people who are smart, you don't go into details. Al-aqilu takfih al-ishara. When you talk to a smart person, you don't need to go to all the details. When you give him a sign, he understands the point. And this Quran is for those who are smart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need to come and explain all the details in the Quran. Because he knows, those who are smart, they get it. So the point is this. For those who ask that, is there any ayah in the Quran where Allah mentioned about the imam, 12 imams or none? I say yes, of course. But you need what? You need a loop. This intellect needs to work before you can find it. But what's in the Quran? Where is it in the Quran? Now listen, Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. A call. From whom? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To whom? To those who believe. What does Allah want from them? He said, أَطِيعُوا Allah. Obey whom? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking mu'mineen that all those of you who believe, there is a responsibility. What is that responsibility? Is to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the first responsibility, because the responsibilities are three. The first one is to obey Allah. Now after I finish with Allah, what is the next responsibility? Allah said, وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Also obey him, the messenger, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is obedience number two. Now obedience number three, Allah said, وَأُولُو الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ, and the leaders of your affairs among yourselves. Here, that's the question. We say that this ayah is the clear evidence about the imam of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wa sallam, for two reasons. Now listen carefully. Reason number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying two ta'a in one ayah. Two obedience. One is ati'u Allah. And then after that, wa ati'u ar-rasul. But when you come to the third one, ulil amr, Allah did not say wa ati'u ulil amr. Listen carefully. Look at the Quran. And remember we said in the beginning, the ulil albab. Now Quran talks about the logic. The ayah says, ati'u Allah. Then obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the one ita'ah. But when he came to the second ta'ah,